Thank you, Diane Furst. I have three questions. My first one is about jobs projection numbers. In a recent meeting, I asked you, Matt, about housing numbers and how we could get the data that underlies that. I have been very frustrated not being able to get information out of PayBank and FTC, so I'm now making my request about the jobs numbers. Would it be possible to find out at a city level how you were calculating those jobs? Because you have Corte Madera down for 700, and I don't know if half of our population is going to stay home writing screenplays or just how you're going to get to that. My second question has to do with displacement. Corte Madera is right on the bay. About a quarter, maybe even a little bit more than that, of our current households are in a FEMA flood zone. Our transportation infrastructure, as well as other infrastructure like sewers, storm drains, are really incredibly vulnerable to sea level. Why are you loading up Corte Madera with so many household numbers? And my third question has to do with displacement. The much maligned WinCup development, this is before my time, folks, but the council and a citizens committee decided to put a whole bunch of the housing there when they loaded up Corte Madera with a huge quota. They made that decision because they didn't want to displace many of our middle-income residents by zoning our multifamily areas of our community, as well as single-family homes, for massive development. We would have lost so many of our friends and neighbors who are living in older, more affordable apartment complexes. Why are you loading up a town that is built out when really one of the only options we would have is to displace our middle income and lower income folks? Thank you.
In terms of households and jobs data, we're happy to sit down with anyone to go over the details. So I think between the draft and the final preferred scenario, we sat down with the Corte Madera planning director, and happy to sit down with you to go through, and I think it's better to sit down one-on-one to go through all the data, to kind of work through exactly what you want to see. I think in terms of loading up the city with housing and jobs numbers, first I just want to say I acknowledge your concern about that. And so, we want to hear that. Again, but I also want to say at the same time that, the county itself in totality is taking on about 1% of the region's housing growth between 2010 and 2040. And that's pretty consistent with the trends that we've seen between 2000 and 2015. So, perhaps we need to sharpen our pencils a bit as we get down to the local level and making sure everything you've got on the books in terms of zoning, other ordinances, to make sure that we really understand the local communities. And I think we are evolving in that way, and we're doing the best we can. It's a very big region. Sea level rise is, I think, an issue that is perplexing all of us. It is coming our way. We have a PDA-focused plan, and a lot of those PDAs are located close to the bay. That is true. And again, these are locally nominated areas for growth, but we are seeing truly that a lot of those PDAs are in areas that are at risk of sea level rise. And I think as we do our regional planning, we have to start really looking at an assessment for those PDAs, not just in terms of the market potential for them, but also in terms of the real threats that they face, and are there strategies at the local level, and can the agencies provide any technical assistance to local governments in terms of how to mitigate and adapt to rising tides, as we all discuss. Of course, at the same time, as you know, that challenge is so difficult because of our legacy of protecting open space and natural areas. So we have a plan here that does not encroach on regional open space. So you can just see from a geographic perspective, when you look at this region, how difficult that is for us. When we have only so little of the geography that will take on growth, But those are the same areas that are that we're seeing those threats to sea level rise. So it's, you know, I just want to acknowledge it's a huge thorny challenge. We feel it too, and we want to get it right. And I think as we move ahead in our regional planning, we're going to work towards those ends.